Today I'm going to show you how a NIS2 information classification policy document looks like and how to fill it out. And this document is very important because it helps you classify or define the levels of confidentiality for each and every piece of information, including your documents, your IT systems and so on, in order actually to define more strict security rules for those information and for those documents that are more sensitive. And with, you know, without this kind of a document that sets clear rules, you wouldn't really know which information needs to be protected more and which information is less sensitive and therefore needs less protection. Okay, here you can see information classification policy from NIS2 documentation toolkit from Advisera. And usually in these kind of documents, you have this first page where you actually display the title of your document, the logo of your company name, these kind of things, and general things about the document, the coding version, date of version, approver, and so on. On the second page, you typically define change history. So basically, how has this document changed throughout time? And table of contents, and then you actually start with the main part of the document. Now, before moving on, let me first explain you this the content, the structure of these documents, purpose, scope, and users. This is where you display why is this document, what is the purpose of this document, who needs to use this document. Reference documents, this is where you display how is this related to NIS2, to let's say other cybersecurity frameworks like ISO 27001. And then comes the section number 3, classified information. This is the main part of your document where you define the main things around classification. So 3.1, steps and responsibilities. So what is the process of actually classifying data and who has the right to do what? Then 3.2, how you actually do this. So what is the classification criteria? How do you know actually if the data is more or less sensitive? What are the confidentiality levels? So is it like top secret or I don't know, confidential, these kind of things. List of authorized persons, when, in which cases you have to create this list. And finally, reclassification. So how often do you need to review the classification levels and define what needs to change? And then 3.3 is about information labeling. So how do you actually label the information with the different types or different levels of classification? And 3.4, handling classified information. This is the lengthiest part of the document, as you will see. And this is where you define how you actually handle, what are the security rules on handling certain types of information based on their classification. Because the principle is that, you know, the more sensitive a document is, the more classified it is as more confidential, the more strict rules, security rules you need to use. And this is exactly what is described in this 3.4. And then 3.5, data masking. So this is basically some, I would say, specific rules on how to hide a certain part of information based on its classification level. And finally, section 4 is about validity and document management. So this is where you define who is the owner of the documents, how often it needs to be reviewed, these kind of things. Okay, let's see now how to fill this out, this document. So if you scroll down, basically what you'll see in this document is there are these square brackets. So this is something, these are the placeholders where you have to fill something out. So in this case, this is your company name. So let's say this is, I don't know, Test Incorporated. Let's say this is how your company is called. And then you have these reference documents. Here the document refers to NIS2 Article 21. And here in the comments, you have already a link to this very article of NIS2. So if you click this link, you would see what exactly says in this document. Of course, you can delete any comments that you don't need anymore. You can also see the references to ISO 27001, so the cybersecurity standard. So it's something that you can leave. And then you have some other references to some other documents within your company. Of course, you can adapt these. So let's say that you do not have the disposal and destruction policy, you simply delete it and move on. The next section is about steps and responsibilities. So you have all these suggested steps here and you can change them. You can change this. Let's say that entering the information asset in the inventory of assets is done by, let's say, the, I don't know, security officer. Okay. And then you move on. Classification criteria. So basically you have the three criteria here for classifying. You can simply delete, let's say, some of these, or you can change, of course, anything that you want to change here. Confidentiality level. Again, you can change the level of confidentiality and how this is labeled. So for example, you have this public, which is unlabeled, and then you have this internal use, and it's labeled by internal use, and so on and so forth. And you can change things here. So you can say that everything that is public must be labeled as public. And then the internal use is simply not labeled. And then that it's basically by default, everything that is not labeled is considered internal use. Okay. Then you move on, list of authorized persons. So this is needed only if there is a higher classification level and you want to define who has the access to this particular piece of information, classification level. Let's say that you want to revisit the classification every, let's say, 1 year. Okay, so you simply change it. And then how the information is labeled separately for digital, paper documents, information systems, emails, and so on. So let's say information systems, the confidentiality level must be indicated in the system access screen as well as in top right corner of each consecutive screen. You can say, okay, we want to have this in top, let's say, or bottom right corner. And then how you handle classified information. So basically this is then defined for each type of information for different levels of confidentiality. Okay, so this is for digital documents, this is for paper documents. And it says, for example, if sent outside of the company, the document must be sent as a registered mail, right? So this is a paper document. So you can say that simply that it can be sent as a normal mail, whereas if it is restricted, doesn't have to go with the to be mailed with a return receipt service, that it can simply be sent as a registered mail. So the document must be sent as registered mail. Okay. Then you move on and define all of these rules for each and every of these levels of classification that you have in columns and for each type of information. And this is how you define these security rules. Okay, now you also should be actually adapting the headers and footers. For example, company name. So we said this is test incorporated. Confidentiality level. Let's say this is internal. And you can also define the version of the document. So let's say this is version 0.2 from a certain date. So let's say this is, I don't know, June 5, 20 something. Okay. So basically, this is how you adapt the documents for your specific company needs. Now, main decisions related to this information classification policy will be around what are the classification levels and also what are the security rules for each of these classification levels. And typically, this is done based on the results of the risk assessment. So what kind of risks you have in the company, but also of your specific laws and regulations. For example, if you are a government body, then you'll probably have some regulation or law specifying the classification level. And this kind of a decision needs to be made between the person in charge of security, so let's say a security officer or CISO, together with the senior management of the company. Now, most common challenges related to this kind of classification policy is not getting commitments for this kind of a document and simply having too much to write with regards to this policy. Now, for getting the commitment, it's very important that you send this kind of a document for review to other heads of the departments in the company, and for them actually to give you some feedback on what they think, how can this document be improved. And this way you're going to get a better document, but you also get their commitment, because if you accept these kind of suggestions, then they will be more committed because they know that part of their, let's say, wishes were also covered in this kind of a document. Also, what you have to do is organize a training and awareness. So through this awareness program, you have to explain to the employees why this kind of classification is important. And through training program, you have to explain them how actually to classify the data, the IT systems, and other things. And to resolve this challenge of having too much to write, I'll show you now how to use the document wizard from Advisera's AI Power Toolkit to speed up the writing of this document. Okay, once you logged into this NIS2 Documentation Toolkit application, you simply scroll down to this folder number 8, Cybersecurity Policies and Procedures, and scroll to this information classification policy, click on it, and then you actually enter this wizard, which helps you speed up the writing of this document. First information that it asks is what is the name of the person to approve this document. So it's already John Smith as pre-entered, and what is the confidentiality level internal use. Now, these fields are already filled out because I previously filled out some other documents in this toolkit, and then the software actually remembers that these are the, let's say, most likely things that are to be entered in all the future documents, and therefore it speeds up your writing. When I click Next, then the system asks who is the owner of this document. Let's say this could be, I don't know, CISO. And by the way, here also you get the suggestion on what this could be. So most likely things that you should enter. And what is the job title of the person to approve this document? So let's say CTO. Then you click Download and the document will be created automatically. So I simply click on it. And what you'll notice is that actually now the document looks a little bit different than from what I've shown you previously. It already has this inserted the logo of the company and the company name, because I already entered this information previously through the software, so this is automatically inserted. Also, you'll notice that the approver now is entered. This is John Smith, and also the confidentiality level internal use, because this is also entered through this wizard, and this is now visible here. Some other things you'll notice that whenever I inserted some certain specific information into the wizard, this is automatically displayed here. In other words, this kind of a wizard, whenever there is a, let's say, a job title, a company name, or something like this, it is something that is automatically inserted based on the information that you previously entered into previous documents. Hope this was helpful, and to see this information classification policy for yourself, sign up for the free trial of NIS2 Toolkit. Click the link to the toolkit in the description below, and you'll be able to see the free demo of this document and also other documents from the toolkit, and you can also try how this document wizard works. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, and you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button below, not to miss my new videos. Thanks for watching!